be on password management, and last subtext is, yes, you really need to pay attention about your password. So, quick show of hands, how many of you use simple passwords? Do you guys know what simple password mean? 4 to 6 characters, all lower cases, no digits, no hires, no special characters. How many of you again? So why do you use special characters? Sorry, why do you use simple characters?
So that I can
type easily. You
can type easily. Remember
easily. Sorry?
Remember easily.
Remember easily.
Unsecured sites, right, which I have any trust, I use simple passwords.
Simple passwords, okay.
Except banking sites.
So that other can have.
Okay. Next. Yeah, sorry?
Except banking sites, where we have to use special characters.
Yeah, they force you to do that, right? So you, I hope you'll understand why they force you to do that by the end of the session. And you're saying one more?
Yeah, actually, sometimes there are no guidelines or something.
Right.
You should follow like this.
Right, okay.
Whatever is easy to
do. So,
everywhere it was like simple passwords. Now they force us to use them.
So you're forced to use that.
Yeah.
interesting. So another question. How many of you use the same password all over, throughout, everywhere? See, I'm a speaker, I'm talking about password management. I see few people who are not using that. So, to you guys, hands up, man. Give these guys a big clap. It's very rare. So,
no, 101 sites
with
passwords, how can we do that?
Sorry?
101 sites we have to register.
Right, so again, by the end of the session, I'll let you know.
Just group them, right? So, emails, you have one password. And you know, random sites you have one password, and banking you have one password.
There was an article on this. They said most of the people uses 3 passwords only.
Right.
Most of the people has 3 passwords.
I have a random password.
Last count, I have 20 passwords.
How will you manage to?
Let's get to that.
We'll give you some suggestions on how you can manage them better.
Sure.
Okay. So about me, I'm Satya. That's what everyone calls me. My full name is Sathyajit, but feel free to call me Satya or Sathyabhat. That's what I'm known on the internet as. I work as a PLSQL developer at CGI, PLSQL Oracle. I work on Oracle databases. I'm a gamer. I love to play a lot of games. I'm also a part-time blogger. Now it's more like ex-part-time blogger because I just don't have the time to manage two things, and I'm just too lazy to write anything. I also moderate a couple of Stack Exchange sites, Stack Overflow. Any of you heard of Stack Overflow? So Stack Exchange is the parent company of Stack Overflow. Sorry? I do community moderation at that, so it becomes very important that I manage my account very well so that it doesn't get hacked, so it doesn't fall into the wrong hands. And of course, there are more important things than my Stack Overflow or Stack Exchange account. I am not an InfoSec guy, so you have your complex InfoSec question. Any InfoSec guys here? No. Okay, one. So I'm not an InfoSec guy, so if I'm saying anything wrong, or if anyone else feels that I'm saying anything wrong, feel free to correct me. I'm all for learning. So I'm giving the speech or talk after what I experienced because of the bad things that I had done in terms of my password management. I'll tell you about my experience probably midway through the session. I'll see how it goes. So, this is true, right? Passwords hold the key to your digital world. Have one password. So, let me ask you a question. You guys stay at your houses. You guys have your lockers. You guys have cupboards, keys. We all use the same key for all the things. We have one key for your car, for your house, for your locker, for your bank locker. So why the difference for your online accounts? It's the same thing, right? Some of them are not high value, some of them are very high value. So real world analogy. Why do you use the same thing? Again, you say, I cannot remember, it becomes very complex. Same thing does with your keys, right? But you're trained to remember different keys, okay. This key has this shape and this number at the ending. Okay, so this is for my house. And this is a small key, only 3 levers, whatnot. This is for my computer drawer, which I have filled with bills and which are not useful. So people have this assumption or this mindset that acha, this site is secure. They have put a nice lock, 128, 256-bit SSL, AES, whatnot. It's going to, nothing's going to happen. Everything's, you know, secure, foolproof, nothing's going to happen. I say everyone falls. And from past record of what I have seen, it's true. They may not fall because of mistakes at their end, but they will fall nonetheless. Because everything is essentially running on software, and software will have vulnerabilities. And people will find ways to figure out how to break into things. So let me give you a brief listing of which other companies have fallen. The Sony PlayStation Network. Do you know how many user accounts were compromised in this?
Somewhere around 1.5 billion.
That's up to...
It's
actually 77 million users. 77 million users. Think about it. Registered it, right? It is claimed that they stored passwords and credit card information in plain text. Of course, Sony will deny it. They have reasons to deny that. So keep this in mind, 77 million, and that's like what, 770 lakh, right? So think about it, that many users. Now you think, right? So you think nobody is going to hack into your account because it contains of no value. Now what if your account is one of those 77 million accounts? How would you defend against them? LinkedIn, very recently. How much? 6.5 million? 6.5 million. Bethesda. Bethesda is a gaming studio which did the very famous Elder Scrolls series of games. This was, I think, in 2010-2011. Gawker Media, Lifehacker, Gizmodo, etc., etc. Again, I think close to 6.5 million. Right? So, their commenting software was the problem. That was broken into. Right. God help you if you use the same password which you use on your commenting system as your banking password or as your work password. So now you know why I say why do you use the same password? That's why I say don't use the same password. I'll come to that. I don't know if people remember this or know about this. Microsoft India Store. This happened again recently. Casualties.
Twice.
Casualty, but thankfully. Separate password, nothing happened. It is rumored that credit card information was stolen, but again, the companies won't accept it, they won't deny it. They'll say, no comments, it's under legal thing, blah, blah, blah. So, see? Blah, blah, blah.
Thank you.
So, some password stats. Easy passwords will be broken. You can keep a 8-character password, and nowadays with GPU, do you guys know what GPUs are? Graphics cards?
Yes.
So graphics cards have become so powerful that they can easily eclipse even our CPUs, the processors. And there are dedicated GPU farms. Rendering farms are there. There are GPU password cracking farms as well. You can get a GPU cracking farm easily. Just go to Amazon, create an AWS instance, bingo. And they charge like what? Some cents per instance? I don't know the exact one. So, you have a password cracking form. And then you have tools like Loafcrack, etc., etc. I won't get into the details because I haven't done the research on that. John the Ripper, etc. So I haven't done research on the breaking part. My focus is on how to make people understand that their passwords are not safe, despite what they think.
But we have things like,
you
know, in Google, if we try to enter more than 3-4 times, we get a picture.
Right.
Gotcha.
That is true. That is when you're trying to break into the web app.
Yes.
What if the web app's backend data itself was stolen? What if, I agree, a lot of websites and all, they have restrictions as to how fast you can enter, how many successive attempts you can do. That is all well and good. But what happens if that data is stolen by someone else into their computers where there is no such restriction? They can brute force it all over, right? So, again, that's why we say keep using hard passwords. during, let me tell you about my incident. This happened about a month after the Sony PlayStation store was, Sony PlayStation network was broken into. So what happened was, I had used the same password for my Gmail account as that of the PlayStation network. Big mistake, number one. Number two, that Gmail account was effectively abandoned since the past 3 years because I had moved from Gmail to Google Apps. So I never bothered paying attention to what is happening in the Gmail account. Number three, that this was broken. PlayStation network was broken. Usernames, passwords, plain text passwords behind it. Not even encrypted, not even hashed, salted, whatnot. Plain text passwords were stolen. So now, less than a month later, I think it was 3 weeks, May 11th, if I'm not mistaken. I remember the dates very well because it was a big, big blunder for me. So May 11th, what happens is, I wake up. I was actually very sleepy at that time. It was 7 o'clock in the morning. And all of a sudden, my phone, Gmail syncs to my phone, right? My phone starts buzzing like crazy. And I see what's happening. I have at least 10 emails saying, your account is compromised, your account is compromised, your account is compromised. I'm like, okay, what the hell is happening? Am I dreaming? Is this real? So, wake up, put on my lenses, don't even go to brush my teeth, I see. I go to the this thing, because my Google Apps was fetching data from my Gmail account. I see my Google Apps, everything is fine. Gmail has that last known activity thing. Everything was fine. I go to my Google Gmail account, there's that red thing. Your account was accessed from an unknown destination. I check, IP address, it geolocates to China, so.
It actually comes from all over the world. For some people it was from Hawaii and some
exactly.
people it was from New York.
For me it was from China.
Okay. They put up the whatever dump they have, the password, they put it up on Facebook.
Right.
Yeah.
So for me it's like red, your account was, and this Gmail passed this, had shown this notification the very next day of the hack. The very next day it was publicly disclosed that Sony PlayStation. So if spammers or hackers or whoever, I'm pretty sure that the database was sold off for X number of million dollars or whatnot. So it took them 3 weeks to probably, you know, feed them into their spamming software, this, that, whatnot. So for 3 weeks, they had access to my personal email, and that too, that email was set as password reset for so many things which I have absolutely no idea about. And I see there, 3 weeks later, the day of the incident, I'm like, I see, oh shit. I go to the sent emails, and voila, all of them. It was a phishing email saying that phishing slash shopping. I think it was beanbags or something. I don't remember. It was quite enough. I was still. You imagine how it is. Your account has been broken into. Your people are like, you know, dude, you're sending spam. What is wrong with you? This is at 7 o'clock in the morning when you have just woken up and you haven't had your coffee as well. So
happened to my HOD.
It can happen to anyone.
She said Viagra.
Thankfully, it was not Viagra for in my case. I'd be like, so I go and.
So for some people, it was like laundry.
So I go and check that out. And you know what made it even worse? Gmail at that time had very recently, just a couple of days ago, because of the PlayStation network hacking, they had introduced a feature where it says, if it thinks that email has been sent from a compromised account, it adds a flag. This email was sent from a compromised account. Be careful of what you say. So the first thing I did was change my password.
It was mandatory. They asked.
Yeah, it is, you know. But people don't do that often. They are like, okay.
Verification thing for Gmail.
Sorry? It was not there.
It was that account.
So.
But there's another thing about that. It becomes very painful when your phone is out.
Yeah.
You got your safety codes.
You
got 10 codes.
I'll speak about two-factor authentication and those backup keys and all.
People even save those keys on their phone.
Yeah, save some phones at phones. Save something for Sathya.
I'll speak about them in a minute, but you're right. But I didn't have two-factor authentication that time. Rather, it was there, but I did not enable it. So that was one of the first catalysts for me to enable two-factor authentication. So, like I was saying, I send a reply, I compose an email and send a reply saying that this is my mistake, I'm sorry for the thing, please do not click any links on anything. And that email which I had sent informing my my friends, my colleagues, my peers, saying that, you know, please do not click, that also gets that also got marked as coming from a compromised account. And I'm pretty sure half of the guys did not get it because it went directly to their spam. So this was a very bad experience for me, more so in the because people know me as the computer guy, the go-to computer guy, right? Something's wrong. Projector is not doing, yeah, go to that fellow. Phone is not booting, Satya, this my phone is not booting, tell me why.
He was bluffing all along.
So when you think you know it all and then something happens to you which destroys that notion that you know it all, it hurts you a lot, right? So I started doubling up on my efforts. So this was the incident based on which, so from that point on, I've been trying to get people to improve their passwords. The success rate has been maybe 2%. Out of 100 people, maybe 2 people will listen, but I'm trying my best. So this is why I'm talking about it. So after on that aftermath of that incident, I started reading a lot about how people manage their passwords and all. Mark Burnett had this great article called How I Collect Passwords. The link is there later. I'll share this slide screen later on. So over a course of 12 years, he collected 6 million unique usernames and passwords. He collected via various means, via Google search hacks, via some people sent it to him. He was actively monitoring sites like Pastebin, where it's easy to get, right? So after 6 million unique usernames and passwords, only 1.3 million passwords were unique. Think about it. So the remaining ones were all used by at least one person. Password reuse. Do not reuse your passwords. Why? One false, everything else false. The list of the top 20 passwords remain the same. Do you know what the most common passwords are?
Password.
So from the Gawker hack, Wall Street Journal did a report on, they captured the data and they did a report on some of the most common used passwords. These are, how many of you use these passwords? Tell me. There's an InfoSec guy who uses the password. What can I say? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Very secure. 6 digits, all numerals, password, ABC 1, 2, 3. Secure passwords, right?
Actually, how can zero be a password?
Some people, some sites don't even have that. Sorry?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is the best password for things like Demonoid and Pirate Bay and all that.
Yeah, yeah.
So even if they get hacked, it's pretty useless to the other rest of them.
Okay, trust no one as a password. Trust no one. You are using trust no one as a password. I mean, come on. Right? So, monkey. I have no idea what was going through the people's mind when they thought of monkey.
How did Gawker allow a secret password?
It's a commenting software.
Zero.
Zero.
Are you coming up with something or is it research?
Maybe they didn't have this. So now you know why banks enforce this. One thing is, like, I hate when banks enforce this, especially when they say you are allowed to use A to Z, 0 to 9, nothing else. I mean, what is the point of that?
That is why people are using ABC 1.
Right. I don't mind that restriction, but I want them to use. I mean, if they don't allow me to use special characters, what's the point in implementing that restriction at all?
People who use ABC 1, 2, 3 make their password ABC 1, 2, 3 dollar.
One funniest fact was in a bank, the password was sent as a plain text.
If I had a penny if I had a paisa for every time I hear about a hack which had where the website stored plain text, right? I'd be a very
important. I myself literally did a WhatsApp capture. I got plain text passwords about your bank.
Yes, so the point is, their security is not foolproof.
Yeah, so
they just want to avoid that.
Right, so in order to avoid that, what they'll do is they'll just disallow this character. That's not the right way, is it? Right?
Most of the signs will disallow only some special characters.
Looking at the password restrictions, like the other day, I tweeted about a picture of Citibank's password restrictions. They don't allow angled brackets greater than lesser than. They don't allow dollars, exclamation, at. So looking from at, ampersand, looking from that, you know that they are running on
a SQL injection
or they are running on a Unix background software, or they have a Unix background in there where the import is sent directly without sanitizing it. And so far, this thing. Citibank, recently I needed to create a new password for my Citibank account. It was not broken or anything. It's just that they disallowed password. They had very strict password restrictions, saying that it must be 16 characters, sorry, 12 characters, I don't remember.
8 characters minimum.
8 characters.
Capitals and small.
Capitals, small, special characters allowed, but the special characters such as angled brackets greater than lesser than, ampersand, semicolons,
dollars,
essentially all the special characters, all the characters which are treated by Unix shell as special characters, reserved characters were not allowed.
The word is limited to 16 characters.
Yeah, yes. Exactly. 16
yes.
characters.
That
and I use 20 characters for minimum 20 characters across some of my most important ones.
Yeah, so 20 characters is normal.
Right.
So what Citibank is doing is a positive thing or
bad? It's a bad thing.
It's a good and a bad thing. It's a good thing because they are forcing you to use a lot more characters as opposed to just A to Z and 0 to 9. They are doing a bad thing by doing things like you cannot use AB. Consecutive letters or not. That is fine. But they're also disallowing you from using special characters.
And
exactly. No, even geeks fail. I tried that.
That is an exercise in frustration. Trust me. That is an exercise in frustration.
It's
worse to be
a
geek. How can you sit and figure out which special characters not to use? My password manager doesn't even allow that. I have to go and put it in exceptions.
Exactly.
They don't know how to code, it's simple. They don't know how to. All you have to do is hash the password, and they are thinking it might get misused by some sort of SQL injection.
Yes.
So, some bad ways of choosing a password. Don't use one which has your first name, last name. I am pretty sure some of you will at least use it. How many of you use this kind of password?
Yeah.
Not anymore.
Coming up. I have. No, not anymore. They still do. Trust me.
There are lots.
Don't use one which has your birth date. Birthday, birth year, whatever it is. Don't use it. Why? Facebook.com/whatever your password profile is. About. Birthday. XXXXX. People do that. I do that. Because I don't use my birth date or birth year in my passwords. Don't use one which is in your current hometown. Foursquare check-ins. I have checked into X place. I became mayor of X place. You just broadcast it to your entire world. And then I'll tell you why you should not use this. Your pet's name. Password reset question, any of these, what is this? Go to facebook.com, public profile. Here's my pet Tommy. So where's your password security then? It's gone, right? You set your password secret to whatever either of these.
But how does the cracker know that itself is a password?
Guess what? If you talk to many people, you'll realize. I'm not a hacker, I'm not an infosec guy, I'm just your ordinary guy who's gotten a little bit of interest in how people manage their passwords and all because of my previous experience. And I did not search for Google for, you know, bad ways of choosing a password. These are things which have come to my mind from my interactions with others. Right?
What about these are your security questions? That's as bad
equal. Yeah, bad ways of choosing password would mean that one of your security questions would be variations of either of these. Dictionary words.
So that's why spelling mistakes come in handy.
Yeah, definitely.
But retyping it is a problem.
Or you can make your dog your mom.
That that works well until when you actually have to reset your password and then what is my dog's name?
I've never figured out what my cat's name is till now. It never works for me.
It's not Jerry.
I can never put my mom's name in my, as my pet's name. What kind of nonsense is that, sir?
Exactly.
Don't use dictionary words because they will be hacked. They will be broken easily by today's GPU-based crackers. You don't believe me? There are just Google for GPU crackers. Even your simple 2,000, 3,000 rupees wala NVIDIA or AMD card will break it in like 5 minutes, your simple one. Even your Intel HD 4000, let's forget about Intel IGP because I don't consider them as graphics, but they are a piece of trash. So that is another different story altogether. Your even your slowest CPU nowadays, dual core whatnot, running at 1.6 GHz, it will break it in no time. You can go have your coffee and come back and like, you'll spit out your coffee because your password is ready. It's like that. So password reset hints which point to publicly available information. And I specifically mentioned, whatever you put on Facebook is not private despite what you choose your privacy settings to be. But tomorrow Facebook will say, we have changed our security settings such that this is now public. Even if it is available for 5 minutes, Google would have indexed that by now. Then, what do you do? You're gone, right? So, the next is bad ways of handling passwords. How people manage their passwords. And password reuse. I mentioned password reuse a lot, because this is a very, very, very bad habit. Learn from my experience of the Sony PlayStation Network hacking and the Gmail listening. You lose it once, everything is gone. You might have lost it at a hack which you didn't even know has happened and somebody has already used it elsewhere and you don't even know all this chain of events has happened until it's too late. Right? Your banking passwords, your bank might give you protection, like they have, will give you liability from protection. No, in financial terms, they'll say your account was broken into, so we will, there's some liability protection against that. But this is not always the case. Case in proof, last month there was big news on majority of the credit card guys, credit card numbers were siphoned off. It was very huge on the newspapers. Some 38 crores worth of not illegal, fraudulent transactions were done based on credit card numbers stolen off. And the best part or the worst part is they still haven't figured out which was the merchant or which was the merchant rather. Which
you're talking about CC Avenue, like that.
No, not CC Avenue.
Like
this is
few months back.
That was 6-7 months back. This was just last month. I got an email, I got a call from ICICI Bank. This was the very next day I'm heading off to Pune. I got a call from ICICI Bank saying, excuse me sir, is this Sathyabhat? I'm like, yeah. Do you have, can you tell me your, oh yeah. If someone asks you for your password, credit card number, on phone, never ever, phone, email, SMS, whatever, never ever, ever, ever give that. Nobody will ever ask you. Sorry? If someone asks you for your password, your internet pin, your credit card number, your credit card CVV especially, never ever ever give it up.
Hill actually does that.
There are a lot of things. Mm. Date of birth, they ask you your PAN card number, or they'll ask you anything. They can ask you practically anything. And they'll give you an offer. They'll tell you,
just refuse. Don't say that.
I got that offer from some guy. He said, can you tell me a credit card number? Like, you have my details on database, so why do you want my credit card number? This is how social engineering. This is how they, another way of getting your details. Social engineering. I'm sorry, sir. We have detected a fraudulent transaction in your bank account. For your safety, can you please tell us your bank account number? And you start to panic, right? And then you give them your bank account number. So, where's the security? Gone.
The problem is, social engineers don't contact the customer directly. They call the customer care and ask for the number.
That is also that. That exploit was used for Amazon, and to, they used that Amazon's details to break into Apple's iTunes. There was something like that. I forgot to address here. But. So these are the kind of incidents I keep tracking, because it gives you a better state of mind as to, you know, follow. You know what you should secure yourself against. So,
give you a credit card number when you order something.
Yeah. I'm like, I refuse to do that. So even if they ask you for your credit card number, right, only mention the last four digits. Last four digits is... Sorry? You are giving them a 24-hour free pass for everything. And some of these
24 minutes is enough for them to lose your money.
And some of these cards, right, they'll have... they'll have a waiver saying that we are not responsible for any fraudulent transactions which happened. Coming back to my ICICI bank thing, so I got a call from ICICI bank saying that, sir, there was a big incident where many credit cards were stolen. For your safety, we request you to block it. And I did not block it because mainly I have the chip-based authentication. I thought I was secure. Thankfully, I was secure. I came back from my trip. I blocked it right away. 2 days later, I get a letter from ICICI Bank saying that on this date we contacted you at this particular time. We requested you to block your card, but you did not say so. Please be advised that from that date going forward, any fraudulent transactions that happen on your card are not covered by our protection. So, if you chose to ignore that, it's your fault, and we will not reimburse you for that. We will not reverse the transaction. So, I'm not saying that all prepaid cards have this kind of waiver, but you should read at each and every term and condition, which another thing which nobody does.
Virtual credit cards.
Yeah, that's what he had mentioned, virtual credit cards.
One-time
use credit cards.
We can control the amount also.
Yeah.
Those don't work in the international.
Some of them work, some of them don't.
There is
So, coming back to my talk, bad ways of using passwords. Don't reuse passwords. Don't write it on post-it notes. I know people who are writing it on post-it notes stuck on their monitors, and I'm talking about corporate users, right? Don't write it on post-it notes. Don't write it on notepads, books, whatever. Don't write it on physical media anywhere. I know this because I've seen people do this.
But what's the problem if you write? I mean, it's going to be a very personal thing.
Someone can come into your office and collect it. They'll throw it to the dustbin. Do you know there are, I forgot the term. Garbage.
Shredders.
There are people who go through garbage to see what they can get. Garbage, I forgot the exact term.
They have special apps.
Garbage. Yeah, something like that. I actually forgot that. There's a specific term for that, so I forgot it.
Housekeeping.
Housekeeping guys are the guys who throw it in the garbage. No, not that. So,
clean desk is one of the reasons for clean desk is this. But it is not the only reason.
So, I'll tell you what, you write your username password on a desk, okay? You toss it out into your dustbin. Whatever is in your dustbin goes to the garbage can. Some guy comes, picks up from the garbage can, he finds a piece of paper, he throws it out on the road. From the road, it goes off, catches someone, finds it, opens it. Far-fetched scenario, hypothetical scenario, yes, very hypothetical. Has it happened? Yes. I know of people who do this. That's why I'm telling you. You've seen this movies? I know people who do this in real life. I talk to them on a daily basis.
I know one person who had a book for passwords only. He didn't trust this online website that they can store passwords or any password manager. You'd write every username and password on his notebook. And if I wanted some access from his account or something, because I was working for him, you would
filter out
your take a sticky note, write.
Don't write it on text files, Excel spreadsheets. Again, same thing. Anything can go anywhere, and
So when that's done,
don't keep it in your Gmail trust. Please. Who does this? I did it.
I do it for other accounts.
Don't do this. Don't do
this.
Right. No, I tell you why you use. So don't do this. Never ever do any of this.
Ciphering mechanism.
Yeah, sure.
It is. Finally, after this session, that we are closing that kind of session in asteroids. We would like all of you to be there and all that.
Don't email your passwords. Nobody will ask. Even if someone asks your password, report it as spam. Gmail has a report as spam option. Wherever you get spam, don't delete it. Click on report it as spam. You are making Gmail better. If you delete it, Gmail won't know it's spam. It'll keep continue distributing the spam. Use machine learning is there. Make machine learning better by helping them, by training them. That's how you do that. Yeah, right. Now Gmail has, when you click on report spam nowadays, Gmail gives you three options. Is this coming from a compromised account? Is this a spam or is this phishing? This was again recently launched.
How it's done?
So, I'm speaking in Gmail in particular because that's what I live on. I live on Chrome and Gmail every day. Hotmail, Live, Yahoo. If you're using Yahoo, I don't know. There was a huge Yahoo vulnerability a couple of days ago, and X number of accounts were stolen again. So, please, whatever email accounts that you're using, if it's so whatever email
two-factor authentication also got compromised.
That was a different. I'll come to that. In a
I have a question.
Yeah.
If I write my password on the paper or even in Gmail draft, I will not write that this is password of my Gmail account. I will just write down that number or password.
Password reuse. You might have used it once. You might have used it on five sites. One of those five sites got cracked. They are not going to sit and read each and everything and say, thinking, is this going to be matching this against this side? No. Brute force hacking. Take a site, take a collection, match this, run this. Doesn't matter.
Doing this thing. They are not doing this manually. So
Nobody is going to sit and think about this.
They're just going to find a vulnerability spot, start attacking at that point of time.
Anything else where you don't want to handle passwords?
There is only one exception to what you are saying about giving your credit card or debit card numbers. When you are reporting it lost, you will obviously need it. Otherwise,
Even then, the last four digits are more than enough for them to.
Most credit cards are either linked to a bank account.
Yeah,
and bank account number.
Yes, so that is an option that you can practice. But at times, if you don't remember your account number, then you might need to do that. And
just go to the bank.
Yes, but then, dude, you lose out on time. Anyone could use your card at that point of time.
There is one more thing actually. Will you especially if it's
credit
card? If it's not HDFC, don't give your credit card number at all. You can be rest assured, it's gone.
Yeah.
Verify this certificate. Stop being lazy and go buy this thing yourself.
I am lazy, that's not going to change.
Another bad way of handling passwords, giving it to your girlfriend.
girlfriend, boyfriend, whatever it is, your preference, but giving it to anyone.
Most people do that, by the way.
That's why
you
should feel.
So I'll just run through the session because I might be running late. So tighten your account. So tighten your accounts. How? Use strong passwords. I don't know how to use a password. I don't know how can I come up with passwords. The best I can come up with is SAT123! Exclamation mark.
Oh, Gmail,
you can try it.
Try what?
I don't know how to come up with strong passwords. What will I do? I'll use my first name, last name, and I'll use a special character. Okay, exclamation mark works best. Fantastic.
Capital letters.
You ask someone else.
Ah, capital letters if you use then. Okay,
the
did
first
I use?
Character is always capital.
So.
That's quite different. Really? First character, not the second one.
Yeah.
Rule zero.
First character, yes, I have one capital letter.
Vibhas, rule
use.
Never tell your password to next others.
Password
never.
No, I'm telling you.
I'm not telling
you. Just
tell
that.
Can
first character is always my capital.
No, no, no. It's common practice.
No. Bank or trend where they say capital, they mean the first pass of capital. First alphabet capital.
How you can.
Capital.
Let's just continue for a minute. So, how you can use a stronger password? Use tools like LastPass, OnePassword, KeePass. These are tools which will generate a password for you. And you can tell them, I will speak specifically of LastPass because that's what I've been using for the past 3 years and I just renewed my subscription for another 5 years. I'm a LastPass premium. It's 400 or 500 bucks a year, well worth it. Okay? Forget about pizza party for one weekend. Buy this. You'll, trust me, you'll sleep a lot better. So, use LastPass. LastPass.
Is there free?
These are password managers called LastPass.
Yeah,
just to exactly
work better.
Yeah. So what I'll tell you, what LastPass does is, you can generate a password. You can give. It can generate password for you. You can tell it how many characters you want. You want 16 characters. You want 5 characters. You can say whether you want numbers, special characters, alphabets. It can generate random characters or it can generate passwords which sound like words, need not be words.
If
and
your LastPass account is hacked,
see, but then
that's a different
thing. That's a different thing.
There is a problem with the password. See, if you are not on your system and you are working on some other system.
I'll come to that. So LastPass is free for your basic use. Only if you need LastPass Premium. You need LastPass premium account for your if you want to use the app on your mobile phones. Otherwise, you can just log into the browser. There from their website, you can access it. One password is I haven't used one password, so I don't know about. So you can probably give a session.
It's
almost same. It's the same thing, right? So LastPass syncs your password across all your devices. Now imagine there is a LastPass Chrome extension. Chrome syncs all your data as well. So wherever you go, if you have Chrome, LastPass gets installed automatically and it is there. LastPass, you can also access your passwords from LastPass website. So it is good. And of course, it is called LastPass because it is supposed to be the last password you are supposed to remember. Have one strong password for your LastPass account and the other ones, you don't have to remember them. Just go to lastpass.com or use the app. Of course, you'll find it very tough that for every time you want to log into a site, you have to go to LastPass and you have to see, you have to search, you have to fetch it. So the LastPass extension for browsers, what it does is it detects which site you're on. It will offer you to autofill. If you want, you can autofill. Otherwise, you can manually enter it, copy paste it. So it's very, very essential to use. It's very simple as well. Yeah.
If you are not using the extension,
mm-hmm.
on the last part website, your password will come up in
clear text. It doesn't come in clear. They don't store any clear text passwords.
How do you put it on the one?
They, whatever LastPass key that, whatever LastPass password you have, they use that. They use a random key generated on your local machine. They encrypt it. They then transfer the encrypted data to their servers. So, even. Sorry?
I'm trying to log in to my Gmail. I don't have an extension. I want to log in.
Right.
Now, Gmail will accept clear text password.
Right.
It won't show to the screen, but the field accepts not a hash of the clear text password. How will I retrieve it from
Gmail? It will be two way hash function. But it's two way hash function. Like it will.
It's a reverse.
On the details of LastPass, I haven't read enough to tell you with authority how it works. There is a site, there's a podcast, GRC, sorry.
Yeah, continue.
Security Now, by, so you can read up on that. I'll add that link here. Your other option is KeePass. KeePass again is another password generator. Use Dropbox to sync it. if you want even more, use TrueCrypt to encrypt your keypass and then put it to Dropbox. I think Ninad does that. No?
Okay.
Some people do that. There are, so the whole point is you don't have to come up with passwords on your own. You don't have to remember passwords. You have to remember one password, which is your master password. Of course, you have to keep that master password very secure, right? On Gmail, on Dropbox, all of these sites use two-factor authentication. How many of you know what two-factor authentication is? Okay, that's reasonable. So basically, two-factor authentication means that in addition to your password, you also need to enter another key, another token, which is not readily available in front of the device that you're using. Banks use this for validating transactions. They send an OTP. Similar way, Google accounts use two-factor authentication. So what you do is, you set up two-factor authentication. When you log in, you enter your username, you enter your password. There is an authenticator app which generates a random number every 60 seconds. So the server knows the algorithm for generation of the number.
It compares with that
and it allows you to let in. So,
by the way, developers, you can actually integrate it into your app.
Yes, actually, the client side code is available for all. It's open source.
Right. And the next thing which people ask me is, but this authenticator app requires internet access. No, that's not true.
No.
There's a big misconception that the two-factor authentication app user requires internet access. It requires internet access for the first time you're setting it up, so that...
No,
it
can, then.
Yeah, for...
No,
six
it does.
Oh, it does? Okay, so let me just finish this off. So you don't need internet access. If you don't have your password, if you don't have a smartphone containing the authenticator, Google provides you with 10 backup keys, one-time keys, by the way, so you can regenerate them. If you don't want to use those backup keys, Google can also send you an SMS of the OTP, just like how banks do. So use two-factor authentication. It is a pain for the first 4 days, 5 days, a week maximum. You'll get used to it. After that, you won't believe how
much...
But then
you can always remember your computer. No? So that
yeah.
That's there.
Let's not get to it.
Yeah.
There are... But that is true. You don't have to enter the password every... you don't have to enter the OTP every time. There's an option where you have, say, remember my computer. So it stores that OTP for 30 days. So it loses that notion of it being an OTP, but every 30 days you'll be prompted for a new password. So Dropbox uses the same thing, they use the same protocol as what Gmail uses, so you can use the Google Authenticator app for two-factor authentication.
You can even secure your AWS Linux instances with this if you want to.
Yeah.
There's a
open source project which uses Google two-factor authentication for SSH authentication.
Yes.
So you have SSH, SSH password key, SSH public key, plus two-factor authentication. That is for the truly paranoid, if you really are that paranoid. Very few people are, but...
Production servers would all need it, if you have them on
internet. So, like I said, you don't need an internet connection. Keep backup keys in handy. If you don't have backup keys, use the SMS thing. And if you don't have, if you're not getting SMS, well then just forget about it for a while. Go for a walk or something.
Google offers to call you.
They do?
Okay.
So it tells me that Google offers to call. So that's.
I guess no, it's
from like two-step. Yeah, it's like two-step.
So coming to my conclusion, don't reuse passwords. Again, I think I'm repeating for the 6th, 7th, I have lost count, but please, if you're reusing your passwords, change them, at least change the ones which you use, which are the most important ones. Changing passwords across 50 sites is a pain, but use tools like LastPass. You will thank your lucky stars that you did that if, God forbid, something happens. Let that incident not, what happened to me, not happen to you. Please do not reuse passwords. If you're re... Sorry?
How do we trust LastPass?
Yes. How do you trust LastPass? Well, I'm not a security guy. LastPass has been vetted by a hardcore security paranoid guy on security now.
If you trust Google, I'm sure you trust LastPass.
Yeah.
So we are bound by something.
That's not necessarily true.
If
you're
out of there, then what can they do?
Then we can sue them because Google, we don't pay them.
No, I don't. I'm not sure about suing and all this that thing, but
legal issues. See, personally, what I do is like I used to use any song.
Listen to this. Listen to this.
So personally, how I manage my passwords.
Listen to this.
I'm talking about myself. So what I do is take any song, any English song, regional song, any song. Okay. Take those English letters.
Yeah.
Take four words.
Yeah.
Okay. 4 or 5 words, whatever is the limit. Okay. And keep those words as like a common for reusability.
Yeah.
And then suffix or prefix, like if I'm using like Twitter, if I'm using Facebook, so prefix or suffix that thing and be specific. Like if you suffix Facebook, you do something like you shuffle those letters or you use a small name for Facebook or whatever.
Be consistent with it. Another way. Yeah.
So what you will do for different websites, you will be having different passwords.
So
and
it's actually
will
a password.
Like all those things. Like
you build it
social letters
like,
and all.
So that's how I make it with 20 passwords.
Another,
it's a password.
Yeah.
Isn't that now a good proof to crack your password? Isn't that a good proof now to crack your password?
No.
Try it.
Listen to me.
Like if you're using any particular website, like
Facebook,
just make sure that you a particular thing like FB, make sure that your password string contains a character called FB or something like that. For each and everything, it will be a unique thing.
See, for suppose Facebook or I do personally. Facebook, it's an 8-word name. So, multiply 8 with, let's say, 3 or 4 or 5. So, embed 24, like, because 8 multiply by 3.
What do you do?
Embed 24 in your password.
Another way.
So, this is the same way.
I have a bigger problem here with that.
Okay.
All the banks, each and every bank,
so nothing
will use
some validation to check.
Your password is gone. So, you have to think about a new password.
Yeah,
that's a bigger problem.
That's why I say use LastPass, OnePass, KeePass, whatever. Generate, let it generate password. You don't forget. You don't have to remember them. You just remember your master password by methods of him. Or my way is take some dialogue which is very familiar to you, which you know. It can be a phrase. It can be your most cherished dialogue from a game, a movie, a lyric. Take the first few letters, or take that entire dialogue itself. Replace some of the letters with special characters. A becomes at, for example. Things like this. Use, be creative. Now, don't go and do.
Or number the words.
Number the words. So all of these things. So I'm about out of time. So to conclude. Don't reuse passwords, don't use easy to guess passwords, don't write them down, use password managers and two-factor authentication. Please, please, please do this, and that's about it. So these are the links, if you want, I'll put this up on my presentation page later. If you want to talk to me, come meet me, I'm Sathyabhat on Twitter, you can ping me there, and yeah. Any questions? Anything else? Yeah. Thank you very much. My first session, by the way, so
yay.
It went nice. It went
scared the shit out of me.